local airport today. Witnesses say the plane slammed into the ground at Ocala International Airport moments before people rushed to the wreckage and pulled out one survivor. WESH 2's Talitha Vickers with all new video from the scene.
News of Alan Golson's death has sent shockwaves across state lines. The 55-year-old CEO of Coliseum Health System in Georgia was piloting this plane that plummeted to the ground.
It was horrible. I don't ever want to see something like that again.
Thick black smoke and a ball of fire captured on this surveillance video from a nearby auto shop gives a glimpse of the horror that unfolded just outside Ocala International Airport.
We heard the engine cut out, and then we heard the explosion.
Inside the mangled frame of this Cessna was 55-year-old Alan Golson and his wife, Carol. People from nearby businesses raced to the scene with fire extinguishers in hand.
Two of my coworkers ran over and pulled the woman out of the plane. Michael just reached in and picked her up, and then two of my other coworkers walked her out away from the building and sat her down with her back, you know, facing us and not so she couldn't see the plane. And they kept trying to pull the pilot out and just couldn't get him.
The pilot, Alan Golson, did not survive. Golson was the CEO of Coliseum Health Services in Georgia and, according to the FAA, took off from Middle Georgia Regional Airport in Macon, headed to Ocala International Airport, but missed the runway 1 mile south of the control tower.
He is someone that's always involved, always pushed us to make a difference in putting patients first, and I think that's the one thing that we're going to miss about Alan, about how much he was committed to the health system and his passion for the people and the patients.
It's the second plane wreck I've seen out near the airport in the last 10 years.
Yeah, we hear planes go over all day long. So when you hear this loud engine and then there's nothing, we knew. I started heading for the door.
Carol Golson was rushed to West Marion Hospital and is reportedly in stable condition. Right now, the FAA and the NTSB is investigating what led up to this crash. Reporting from Marion County, Talitha Vickers,